So this is the problem which is asked in ESE 2003. This is ESE 2003 question. So consider the circuit as shown below, which has current dependent source. This is the current dependent source. Then we have to calculate the value of V2 by V1, the value of voltage across this current dependent source to the supply voltage V1. Okay. Solution. So, by default he provides the current direction in the loop 1, that is, this is I, right? Alpha is nothing but like this, this is alpha I. Okay, see, current dependent current source, this is alpha I. Okay, then from loop 1, what is the equation starting from this? minus V1 plus I into R, right? Coming to this branch is present between loop 1 and loop 2. So, we are writing with respect to loop 1, right? So, R into, see the current direction, this is like this and this is also like this, no? So, I plus alpha I through this branch, that is plus R into I plus alpha I, right, which is equals to 0. So, right, starting from this minus V 1 plus I into R plus R into, see the current direction, this is I, this is alpha I plus I into I, sorry, I plus alpha I into R is nothing but voltage drop. So, from this I R alpha is equals to V 1. So, from this we can 1 plus 1 plus alpha, that is, you can get 2 plus alpha is equals to V 1, this is 1. Okay. Next, from loop 2, we can write only one branch, we have only the current in this loop is nothing but alpha I, and we have only one branch, that is R into R with respect to loop 2, right? So, R into alpha I plus I, R into alpha I plus I, right? R into alpha I plus I, which is from negative to, for example, if we, the voltage across this dependent current source is minus plus. So, like this we can write minus V 2 plus R into alpha plus I is equals to 0, that is minus V 2 is equals to 0. So, from this I into R 1 plus alpha is equals to V 2, this is 2. So, from 1 and 2, what he needs? V 2 by V 1, no? So, V 2 by V 1, which is equals to, what is V 2? I into R 1 plus alpha by I into R 2 plus alpha. From this, I R gets cancelled. Therefore, we have 1 plus alpha by 2 plus alpha. This is the required answer. Then the option is C. Next problem is, in the circuit shown, the current I1 we have to calculate. This is the problem which is asked in ESE 2011. So, from this we have to calculate the current I1. So, from this current dependent current source, we have to calculate the current I1. So, the examiner provides the current direction, that is, this is I1, no? Clockwise, this is phi I1, that is it. From this we can calculate the current I1. So, from loop 1, starting from this minus 250 plus 2.5 into I1 plus 10 into
see the current direction, I1 is downwards, phi I1 is also downwards. So, I1 plus phi I1 is equals to 0, that's it. So, 2 point I1 plus 6 I1, 60 minus 250 plus 2.5 I1 plus this is 60 I1 is equals to 0. That is 62.5 I1 is equals to 250. Therefore, I1 is equals to 250 by 62.5, which is equals to I1 equals to 4 amps. I1 is equals to 4 amps. That is option A is correct.
Next question. In the circuit shown in figure, the value of current I, we have to calculate the value of current I. So, the examiner provides the proper current direction I, we have to calculate this current. So, this is voltage controlled voltage source. See, we have plus minus. So, this is voltage controlled voltage source. Okay. This is gate 2008 for 2 marks, for 2 marks. Okay. So, he provides the current direction like this and we have to assume our current, that is I1, say. Okay. That's it. From loop 1, okay, from loop 1, starting from this, minus 5 plus 1 into I1, that is I1 plus coming to this branch, this is also, there is no connection between this point and this point, right. So, this current I1 is exclusively for this branch only. Therefore, plus I1 only, which is equals to 0, that is it. Okay. See, this current I1 is for this element and this element, that is it. So, minus 5 plus I1 into 1 plus 1, 2 I1. So, minus 5 plus 2 I1 is equals to 0. From this, I1 is equals to what? 2.5 amps. We have the current I1, that is 2.5. Like that, from loop 2 we have to write, from loop 2, see, from loop 2, this is loop 2, no? The examiner has provided the current direction, starting from this, minus 4 VAB plus 3 I plus again this current is exclusively for this branch only plus I, right, which is equals to 0. See, there is no connection between these two branches, but he provides, this is node A, this is node B. Between these two nodes, we have voltage VAB, that is it. Okay? So, minus 4 VAB plus 3 I plus I. So, like this, 4 VAB is equals to 4 I. From this, 4, 4 get cancelled, VAB equals to I. We have VAB is equals to I. Right? Next, see, this is node A, this is node B. Whatever the voltage at this node A, that is VA, right? VA is equals to what? The current I1 into what? The branch resistance is 1, which is equals to I1. VA is equals to I1, which is equals to what? 2.5 amps of current is I1, that is VA equals to I1. Therefore, 2.5 volts, VA is equals to 2.5 volts. Like that, VB is equals to what? I into 1, right, which is equals to I. So, VB equals to I. We know that VAB is equals to VA minus VB, VA minus VB. So, but this is 1, VAB equals to I, VAB equals to VA minus VB. Therefore, this is I, which is equals to what is the value of VA? 2.5. What about VB, which is also I, right? Which is also I. Therefore, 2I is equals to 2.5. I is equals to 1.25. Very important problem this is. Simple. From loop 1, we have this equation I1 equals to 2.5. From loop 2, we have VAB equals to I, that is it. But
Later, we have to calculate the voltage at this node VA equals to I 1 into 1. Okay, this is nothing but plus minus. This is VA like this plus. Sorry, already provided. No, this is VB. Okay, so VA minus VB equals to VAB. So from this VA equals to I 1 into 1, 2.5 volts. VB equals to I. We all know that VA equals VA minus VB, therefore VAB is equals to I is equals to VA, we all know that 2.5 minus VB is nothing but I. So from this I equals to 1.25 amps. This is gate 2008 2 marks problem. Next problem is, in the circuit shown in figure, the node voltage VA is how much? So we have to calculate the node voltage at this point. The node voltage at this point A. This is the node A, right? You have to calculate the voltage at this point. So he, from the circuit, he provided the I1 current direction, that is like this. So by using source transformation principle, we can convert this current source to voltage source. Okay. So this is gate 2016 problem. Here you can convert. Okay, the modified circuit will become 5 into 5, 25. That is, see, arrow direction is upwards, that is plus minus. Minus plus, right? Again 5, again 5, then plus minus 10 volts, 5. 5, this is A, this is the given current direction I 1, this is 5 into 5, 25 volts, sorry, we have this branch resistance, right, connected in series, that is it. So this is 5, this is 10 I 1. So this is given direction I 1, we can assume our current direction, that is I, that is it. We have to calculate the node voltage at this point V A. So from loop 1, starting from this, minus 25 plus 5 into I, right, plus 5 into I minus I 1, right, plus 5 into I minus I 1. Again, this is current control voltage source. This 10 I 1 is nothing but what? Voltage value. Therefore, 5 into I minus I 1 minus 10 I 1, right, minus 10 I 1, which is equals to 0. That is it. See, minus 25 plus 5 into I plus 5 into I minus I 1, see, minus and plus, that is why minus 10 I 1 equals to 0. That is it. So, from this 5 I plus 5 10 I minus 5 I 1, that is 10 I minus 5 I 1, 10 15 I 1 is equals to 25. Okay, from this 2 I minus 3 I 1 is equals to 5. This is equation 1. Okay, next from loop 2. See, from this loop to, see the current direction like this, starting from this 10 I 1 plus 5 into I 1 minus I plus 5 into I 1 minus I, that is it, plus the current in this loop is nothing but through this branch 5 plus 5, which are connected in series. So 5 plus 5, 10, 10 into I 1, or you can write 5 I 1 plus 5 I 1 coming to this source plus 10 is equals to 0, that is it. So 10 plus 5, 15 plus 10, 25 I 1 minus 5 I plus 10 is equals to 0. Therefore, 5 I 1 minus I plus 2 is equals to 0. This is 2. From 1 and 2, 1 and 2,
I is equals to 19 by 7 amps we will get, and I1 is equals to 1 by 7 amps we will get. Okay, just by using calci you have to solve these two equations. After that we will get I equals to 19 by 7 capital I1 equals to 1 by 7 amps. Next we have to calculate what? The node voltage at this point VA. So what is VA? A is nothing but what? The node voltage VA is, which is VA is equals to, see we have to calculate the voltage at this point, therefore supply voltage minus drop 25 minus 5 into I, which is equals to VA, which is equals to 25 minus 5 into I, or which is equals to 25 minus 5 into I equals to VA, right? There is no problem at all. Or the voltage at this position is nothing but also VA. 25 minus 5I is equals to the voltage at this, between these two terminals. See, so from this equation, 5 into I minus I1 minus 10 I1 equals to 25 minus 5I, which is equals to VA. Therefore, 5 into C, 5 into I minus I1 minus 10 I, minus I1 minus 10 I1, which is nothing but VA. Very important observation, just okay. See, we have to calculate the voltage at this point, therefore total voltage minus drop equals to VA, that is 25 minus 5I, which is equals to VA. 5 into I minus I1 plus minus 10 I1 is nothing but also VA. Therefore, VA is equals to 25 minus 5 into, what is the value of I? 19 by 7, which is equals to IT by 7. You can get IT by 7, which is equals to 11.42 volts, 11.42 volts, or VA is equals to 5 into, what is the value of I? 19 by 7 minus I1 1 by 7 minus 10 I1, that is 1 by 7, which is equals to 90 by 7 minus 10 by 7, which is equals to 80 by 7. Therefore, VA is equals to 11.42 volts. At any case, we will get the same answer. See, from this also we can get 11.42, from this also we can get 11.42. Therefore, the answer is 11.42. Next one is, the state equations for the current I1 shown in figure. So, this is the current through this branch I1 in terms of the voltage Vx and the independent source V. Now, so we have to calculate the state equations of this branch current I1 in terms of Vx and V. From this circuit we have to calculate. So, this is gate 2007 problem. So, given direction is I1 through this branch, I2 in this loop. So, I2 is exclusively for this loop, but I1 is only for this branch. I1 is only for this branch. Therefore, we can assume our current direction in loop 1, that is I. Therefore, I in loop 1, that is I is equals to I1, I2, that is it, right? Solution from circuit, I is equals to I1 plus I2, means the current through this branch I1 with respect to loop 1, I minus I2, see I minus I2 is nothing but I1, satisfied. With respect to loop 2, I2 minus I, that is I1, I2 minus I is nothing but minus I1. So, from this, with respect to loop 1, with respect to loop 1, the current I1 is nothing but what? I minus I2, right? With respect to loop 2, I2, because this is more dominant, I2 minus I, I2 minus I is nothing but what? Minus I1. these observations are important. So with respect to loop 1, I1 is nothing but I minus I2. With respect to loop 2, I2 minus I is nothing but minus I1. Okay? Therefore, from loop 1, starting from this, minus V plus 3 into I plus C. The voltage across this inductor is nothing but VL. So, he mentioned that VL equals to VX. Okay? VX plus VX. Then the current through this branch we can calculate I1. That is, this is inductor, no? Here, this is also inductor, but he provides the voltage across inductor is Vx, no? See the options, Vx, we have Vx. But he didn't mention anything. Just he mentioned only current through this branch. Therefore, the voltage across the inductor is nothing but what? L into di by dt, right? Therefore, L into di1 by dt through this branch, right? Minus, what about the remaining current? Okay, di1 by dt, which is equals to 0. That's it. Because the current through this branch is only I1, no? So, there is no need of substituting I minus I2. Okay? Or you can wish you can substitute, that is L into d by dt of, with respect to loop 1, I minus I2, 0. But see the options. In options, we don't have any term of I2. Only we have di1 by dt, that's it, only we have this term di1 by dt. So, there is no need of substituting all this. From this minus V, we don't have any term of I, see, only we have I1, Vx, I1, V, that's it. Therefore, substitute this 3 into, what is I, I1 plus I2, I1 plus I2 plus Vx plus, what is the value of L, 0.5 into di1 by dt, okay, which is equals to 0. See, from this options we don't have any term of current I2. So, from this we can get the value of I2. So, 3 I1 plus 3 I2 plus Vx plus 0.5 di1 by dt is equals to V. Therefore, 3 I2 is equals to V minus 3 I1 minus Vx minus 0.5 di1 by dt, di1 by dt. Therefore, I2 is equals to V by 3 minus I1 minus Vx by 3 minus 0.5 by 3 di1 by dt. That is it. So, this is from loop 1. This is from loop 1. Okay? Same from loop 2, you can calculate starting from this minus 0.2 Vx plus C. Here also, here most dominant current is nothing but what? I2. Why I2? With respect to loop 2, we have to write, no? So, I2 minus I through this branch. That is, I2 minus I is nothing but what? Minus I1. Therefore, minus 0.5 into di1 by dt. I think you got my point, right? So, with respect to I2 minus I, we have to write with respect to loop 2. Therefore, I2 minus I. So, that is why minus 0.5 into di1 by dt plus 5 into I2 is equals to 0. That is it. Only we have 1, 2, 3. From this, I2 is equals to what? 5 I2 is equals to 0.2 Vx plus 0.5 di1 by dt. Therefore, I2 is equals to 0.2 by 5 plus Vx plus 0.5 by 5 di1 by dt. That is it. This is 2, this is 1. Equate 1 and 2. So, I2 value of current is same, no? I2 is same. Here also I2 equals something, no? So, equate 1 and 2. 1 and 2. So, from this we can get
di1 by dt is equals to minus 1.4 phi vx minus 3.75 i1 plus 5 by 4 phi. So this is the answer we will get. Di1 by dt, only we have terms c, only we have terms v I1 Vx Di1. So Di1 is there, Di1 Vx I1 V, that's it. See, Vx I1 only, Vx I1. So from this, if we equate equation 1 and 2, we will get option 1. Di1 by dt equals to minus 1.4 Vx minus 3.75 I1 plus 5 by 4 V.